Okay, it's recording. Hello and welcome back. If you're new, hi, my name is Rich and welcome to Life of RGR. I had a wild week to say the least, but I feel like every week is something new, something even more wild than the last one. This week was a lot of just getting used to school being at full pace. I had to switch a class, and so I had to like redo everything for the class that I missed last week, which was a lot of work. And then on top of that, it was a massive week at work because we had style out for our fall 21 collection. And style out is basically before fashion shows like New York Fashion Week, which should have been coming up, or I guess kind of sort of. Some people are doing shows, some people aren't, but we're not doing a show. But basically, style up basically means where stylists come in and they pair together clothes and shoes and jewelry and whatever other garments, and then they put them on a specific model and then they try them all on and they pick out like the full-blown looks for a runway show. But since we're not doing a runway show, we had style out, but it was just for the lookbooks that we're making and putting together, so like basically the photo shoots that we're doing. So it wasn't as chaotic as I guess it normally is, but it was still pretty chaotic. Lots of work to be done, but it was a wonderful experience and I learned so much. I've learned so much this week. I feel like every week I'm just learning at like this insane curve, which is really exciting, but also a lot of work. Other than that, this week Pizza Boy, I thought he got to know about the blog, which would be a very big thing because I've never had like a... This is super new. It's like 4 months old, 4.5 months old. And so I've never had to like have that confrontation with one of the boys that I've talked to. I think one of them knew about it. He just didn't mention it. But yeah, I've never really had to have like the full-blown confrontation. And so I thought that was gonna be something new that I had to go through, but it was a false alarm. We're good. So how it works is that when I do talk about boys, I only say all of the good stuff, and that's why you guys always think they're the ones, because I never say any of the bad stuff, and I never will, because we like to keep it classy in here. I love sharing my life, but I would never slander anyone on the internet. They're all really good people, but yeah, I always want to keep it kind of good around, so if they ever did read it, no matter what our relationship, me and whoever it may be, our relationship is, it's only good things and they can only be flattered by the things that I say about them. But mostly I try to keep it to stuff about me and my experiences with them from my perspective, if that makes sense. So not much about their lives or whatever. Anyways, beyond that, basically what happened was he texted me a few days ago. I literally recorded it right after it happened, so you'll see a clip in here. But my friend Sophie and I were out having a photo shoot and she's like, oh, you got a text from him. And then we opened it up and he was basically like, oh, hey Rish, like fish or something like that. And that's a direct kind of quote from my About Me page on my blog. And so I assumed that he had picked it up from there and he was just dropping hints and trying to mess with me because I know that he loves to mess with me. However, apparently I just have a really shitty memory and I had explained it to him at some point in the past. And so then we had to have this really funny FaceTime call where I was like trying to tiptoe around it and not like say it out loud. And he didn't know what was going on. And he was like, what are you trying to say? And I thought he was messing with me because he messes with me all the time. This is like that one thing where like he cried wolf or whatever. Anyways, he like always messes with me. So I assumed he was messing with me again, but no, this time it wasn't him messing with me. It was just me thinking he was. And so yeah, it's still a secret. Yeah, not a secret, but it's still, I'm still undercover, whatever you want to call it. We're in the clear. I feel like I would still talk about him if he knew about it. But yeah, the sunlight is kind of beautiful, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like I should explain my outfit real quick and then you can get onto the video. So I slicked my hair back, I did this little hairstyle. It's one of my favorites, especially in the summer. It's so much fun and it like makes you look very fun and interesting. Also, I got curtain bangs and around Christmas, and it was one of those things that I was like, okay, I need to do it to know whether or not I like it, and verdict is I don't like it just because I can't slick my hair back like this. It took a long time for me to be able to, just because my bangs were so short that they would fall out, and when I would part my hair and then pull it back and try to slick it back like down here in a till low bun, it just wouldn't work. So I don't love curtain bangs. I'm waiting for them to grow out so I can just enjoy my hair longer. But yeah, here's the hairstyle, slicked back with some hairspray. I have like half a face of makeup. I got some jewelry on. This is from Serafina Jewelry. This is a family pendant. People were asking about my rings. I did my nails, so I feel like I should do a ring tour. I really wanna show you my nails. There are my nails. I've showed them like 4 times in this vlog so far. This ring is my great-grandmother's wedding ring. I was very lucky to be the one in our family that got it. This is from NYC Jewelry Shop. I've plugged them like 1,001 times, but if you haven't heard it already, NYC Jewelry Shop is the plug. This one is from Tiffany's, and this one was my graduation present from Louis Vuitton. And anyways, these earrings, this one is from NYC Jewelry Shop, and this one is from Amazon. Anyways, also, I started this new thing where I put like I put the bigger hoop on the second hole and the smaller hoop on the first hole, and I'm really digging it. Try it if you haven't. Anyways, I'll let you go to the video. I've been talking for way too long. Okay, bye. The sunset's just really pretty. I get so distracted so easily. Hello. Actually, my favorite memory ever is dancing. Okay, so I always say that I want to marry a man that can dance. And a month and a half ago, my friends and I hung out with these professional soccer players, and it was like 3 brothers, and they're from Mexico originally. And we like had this really good night, and then we started listening to Maluma, and then we started dancing bachata to Maluma, and I was like, that's hot. Anyways, good memories. Anyways, happy Saturday. I spent the entire day sketching for work, even though I didn't know that I was going to because I had a bunch of other things to do. Lisa and I cleaned up. Our toilet overflowed, and so there was shit all over the ground of our bathroom. And so Natalia cleaned half of it, and then she had to go somewhere. So Lisa and I literally mopped up the rest of the shit off the ground. I'm literally not kidding you. And then we disinfected everything, so that was my Saturday. And now I'm going to dinner with Sophie. I haven't seen her since she got back into town. You'll see a bunch of her because we're really good friends. But yeah, we're going to a rooftop place that has like little igloo tent type things. And I'll take you guys along and film it. And I'm really just excited to see her because it's been a while. And I'm really excited for good food. We're kind of sort of celebrating the fact that I hit 100K on TikTok because I haven't done any, well, I mean, there's always reason to celebrate. So that's what our reason is tonight. And I'm really excited. I put on my jewelry just to go to the bodega. Then I keep it with me just so that I'm feeling safe. I'm Fendi on my body, but my feet is in bodega. Bitch, I'm getting money, guess I feel I got a head in this motherfucker. I'm at dinner with Sophie. We're in a little igloo. Look.
I keep putting my tongue out.
It's so cool.
Hello. Oh my god, that was embarrassing.
Hello. So it's like 2 a.m. I'm waiting for my Lyft. It's almost here. And we just went to meet our friends, but there was one new person. And we were playing poker, and he was across the table, and he was quite literally the most beautiful human being I've ever seen in my entire life. I wish I got a video, but that would be kind of creepy. I wish he walked out right now, but good God. Hello. I'm a little bit tipped. I'm not gonna finish the word, that's what we're gonna call it. And my roommates are asleep, but I just wanted to inform you that I met the most beautiful man I've ever seen in my entire life, and I think I just fell in love at first sight, even though he definitely didn't fall in love with me. And as I was leaving,
his brother was walking in, and then his brother started like flirting with me, and then he asked me for my number, so I gave it to him. And then his brother started texting me once I left, but I don't want to talk to his brother because I find him cute, but he never asked me for my number, and now I'm just sad. Like, I don't know what to do. Somebody please help. He's so pretty. I don't see how
some folks can be so. So we are taking pictures. So I'm going out to Soho, and I need to make it before the sun sets. You probably can't hear me. It's really darn loud, but my phone is on 100%, but Sophie was just taking pictures of me.
Yes.
We were doing a little photo shoot, and I got a text.
About fish.
About fish. And then I opened it, and it goes, how's it going, Rish? Like fish. And if you read the blog, you know what's up.
Direct blog.
Direct
post.
Blog quote.
Quote. Yeah.
Pizza boy knows. Cat's out of the bag. I have 1% to document this. Yeah, it's a wild fucking Sunday. Good morning. I'm in Times Square. I just got off the subway to go to work. And as I was getting off, so basically like what happens is you get out of the subway station and there's like little exits, but you can't turn around and go back in through them. You can only go out. So I walked up the turnstile, and to leave, there's this tiny little exit, like tiny little staircase, and only one person, it's super narrow, so only one person can fit through it. And then what happened is, as I was leaving, I walked out the turnstile, so I couldn't turn around, and right there, standing at the bottom of the stairs, was this really scary person. I don't know, I think they were like on some drugs. They were fucking going bonkers, and they were just like definitely on something, and there was no way for me to like turn around. And they were just staring in the eyes, and I was just staring at them. And the thing with that is that, like, if you put your head down and you don't look at them, but, like, you're very aware of your surroundings, nothing bad ever happens. But if you make eye contact, I feel like that's when shit gets wild. And so I didn't realize that I looked straight at them. They looked straight at me and made eye contact. That was so scary. And then somehow I, like, just sprinted past them in this tiny, narrow hallway. And now I'm still alive. That was really scary though, and they like looked very aggressive. Things like this happen on a daily basis, and I know that if it happened like a year and a half ago when I was like in like suburban Illinois or something, it would have shook me to my core for the rest of the week. And it just happened, and I like brushed it off as if it wasn't a big deal. Hello! Oh good, it's raining. I haven't recorded much today just because I've been so busy, but this is kind of my first time giving an update and I have so much to say. First off, it was a really good day at work, and I got a hair dryer, two curling irons, and like one of like the heated brushes that straightens your hair. Just because my boss and Mateo are like, you can have them, like we don't have models that we need them for, and they're brand new and we bought them before COVID hit, like right before the show last year, and so they just gave me it, and now I have so many expensive hair like tools. Anyways, that's really cool for starters. Secondly, I'm just kind of like, sometimes I need to pinch myself because things are really wild. People always text me and they're like, oh my gosh, you're living my dream. And I think it's important to know that I'm also finally living my dream as well.
Good morning. I look like a mess, but when do I not?
It's 7 o'clock. I slept at 4:30 last night, so I only got like 2.5 hours of sleep. But at least the sunrise is pretty. And today is the big shoot day. It just hit midnight. I don't know what day it is. Actually, I don't even know what the date today is. I swear to God, if you put a gun to my head right now, I could not tell you anything but what time it is. That it's midnight right now and where I am, which is in my apartment. Yeah, I'm eating a straight ball of burrata because I haven't had time to do groceries for the past 3.5 weeks. Because I get back, like, I finish my stuff for the day at 11 and then I wake up and I'm out of the door by 7 a.m. And I don't think anything's open between 11 and 7. And so I've been lasting off of everything that I have, and now I'm fucking scavenging on burrata, like a straight ball of, this is so unhealthy. This is like 500 calories and so not nutritious, but I'm eating a straight ball of burrata for dinner at midnight. I got 3 hours of sleep last night. I slept at 4:30 a.m. Woke up at 7. To say the least, I'm not very healthy right now. And like, I think my mental health is kind of faltering. Not in the sense of like, when I first got here, I went through like hella lows. Also very much highs. Like most of it was high, but like I went through lows every now and then, and they were really shitty, where like I was like sad and like homesick and like just really like my heart hurt. My heart doesn't hurt right now, which is a very good thing. I'm really happy with everything that I'm doing. Like, I'm not sad. I'm just like mentally overwhelmed. Or I don't think I'm even mentally overwhelmed. Like, my brain is like just at capacity. I'm just overwhelmed because I don't have enough time. I don't have enough minutes, seconds, hours in a day to do everything that I need to do. And that's a bit stressful. I wish I was like Hermione, you know, in like Harry Potter, where she like has the, what's it called, time turner? Maybe, I think. Don't roast me if I said it wrong. I think it's time turner, but yeah. And she like spins it, and then she can like go to her classes and like take lots of classes. Anyways, I wish I had one of those, and I could like turn it at the end of like a long work day, and then I go back to the beginning of the day, and then I just take all of my classes, and everything is just amazing in the world. But no, I'm not Hermione Granger. So I'm eating a ball of burrata at midnight. Yeah, I think I really need to get my shit together. I don't know. I'm still trying to figure out if either I spread myself too thin or if I'm still just getting acclimated to having such a busy schedule. Yeah, I'm trying to figure it out. Everything looks really nice from the outside. Like, my life looks really nice, and it is extremely wonderful. I love it, but like, I don't show that. Like, I do say it, I overshare all the time, but I just want you guys to know that like, my mental health, like, I get very overwhelmed as well because I'm also human. Anyways, I'm gonna enjoy my burrata and then go to sleep.
So good.
Good morning. I'm still in bed. It's 10:30. I took that video late last night, like around midnight, not that late. And I think somebody out there heard my prayers. I haven't gotten out of bed yet, and I really should have been at work, but in some odd, twisted, really weird way, I got an email this morning saying that somebody that came in for our style out yesterday tested positive. And everyone like wears masks and like limited numbers and stuff like that in office. Oh shit. Wait, let me finish this in a second. Oh my God, miracles are real. Okay. While I was recording that, I got a phone call from a testing center that I made an appointment at, because I somehow got a spot at a testing center at 12 o'clock today in Queens, and so I have to trek out to Queens, which is like a 40-minute subway ride, but I don't mind. But they have an on-site lab, which means I can get all of my results today without paying any monies, which is so nice. I really appreciate that, like, I live in a city at the moment, because I've seen how hard it is to get COVID tests and get COVID tests quickly and for free in places that are a bit more rural. Like, when I was in Florida, I had to get tested. and in New York, it's just so much easier, which I'm so grateful for. Anyways, back to whatever I was saying. I was saying that somebody at work tested positive, which means that I can't go back to work. We like got a big email and I can't go back to work until I show a negative test. But that means that until I send them my negative test, I can just work from home, which is a break that I really, actually really, really need. And I'm just so happy. Some girls ain't got no pride at all. No, some are just dolls. Yes. All you're getting is I'm out. I just got it. I didn't get my flu shot once upon a time because they didn't have my insurance right, and so I ended up getting a flu shot now too. Look, I'm getting so much done today. And then I got tested. Also, on top of everything, I'm really scared of shots, especially when I have to get them alone. But I find it so funny, because for me, like, I get my entire fucking body lasered from head to toe. Like, I should not be able to feel pain anymore, but it's like a mental block that I have with needles specifically. But yeah, everything's good. Now I think I passed by a nail salon and I really want to get my nails like cleaned off. So I think that's what I'm going to do right now because I have a whole day. Hello. So I just left the nail salon and my nails look so good. Look at them. I forgot how much I miss my natural nails. So I'm in Queens. Oh, I see it. I'm in Queens and I was looking on the map and I realized that there's like different areas that are different cultures, probably just like evolved over time and kind of became like a neighborhood full of that culture. But there's like Korean, there's Thai, there's also Indian, and I saw it because I saw Patel Brothers on the map. I don't need anything, so I didn't stop Patel Brothers, but it's good to know that it's there. But anyways, I wanted to make Penang curry and I've been thinking about it forever and I've been eating freezer food and balls of burrata because I haven't had a chance to cook. But I finally stopped. I stopped at like the Thai area and I found this market right there. It's called Three Aunties Thai Market and I'm gonna stop there and I'm gonna get stuff to make Penang curry. I feel like nobody actually gives a shit, but I want to do a haul when I get back home. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. I need to do a favor for a friend. Every time I pass an Equinox, all I can think about is how men that go to Equinox don't ever say that they're going to the gym. They always say that they're going to Equinox because the whole point of going to the gym is to flex that they're going to Equinox. I'm back home.
Look how pretty my nails are. I just did them.
I did my nails.
This is really impressive. I'm extremely proud of myself.
We're walking to Trader Joe's so I can pick up a new shoddy from
the trader named Joe.
The trader named Joe.
You all love him.
Because every time I go to Trader Joe's, it looks like my bumblebee just like came to life.
So true.
So,
as always, keep.
Hello! Okay, mm-hmm. I just got back and I've always wanted to do this, and so I'm finally gonna do it. But here's my Trader Joe's haul. I haven't done groceries in the past 3.5 weeks, so this is literally everything's emptied out, and these are my groceries until they fully run out, and I have to go again and make time to go because it's a trek every time I go, and I'm very busy. I used to eat really, really healthy. When I live alone, I generally eat healthy and like watch every meal. And now that I'm working, I found that I like, and I'm so busy all the time, I found that I just can't do it anymore. I feel like you need to give and take some places, and that's where I'm just letting go. With all the stress that I'm under right now, I feel like, you know, you just need to, there needs to be something good in my day. So it's gonna be the food that I eat. I used to like eat to sustain and live, and now I'm learning to eat and to like enjoy, which is a whole different vibe of eating. As you will see in this haul, my mom's gonna whoop my ass for all the gross shit that I bought, but you know, it is what it is. We're gonna start off with this, super festive. They're raspberry hearts. They're like little cookies, the ones with the jam on the middle, in the middle, and I'm super excited. I've never tried them. Fun fact, Valentine's Day is my favorite holiday ever since I was little. Then I got this mushroom pasta. I get it every time I go. Slaps. Anything with truffles, anything with mushrooms are my favorite. This sauce is the only creamy sauce that they have, like creamy marinara sauce. Like everything else is full-blown marinara, so I always get this one because I like it a bit more like on the vodka side. And then I got these oranges. I feel like this is not in order, sorry, it's a mess. But they're basically cuties, but they're bigger and they're also seedless, which is super dope because I like take two to work. And I never end up eating them, but I always have the flexibility of eating them and being healthy if I want to. You know? Vibes. Anyways, then I got bell peppers and ginger and a few other things. The rest of the ingredients that I need for making my Thai food that I was really excited about. And then I got milk chocolate covered mini pretzels. You know? Super healthy up in here. I love burrata. Burrata is my favorite cheese, but then I saw these and I didn't pick up burrata because this, I don't know, I haven't had these since I was like in high school. They just look so good. Then I got waffles. I always get blueberry waffles, like two boxes of them, but today I decided to switch it up. Oh my gosh, these are gluten-free. Oh no. Okay, well I got regular toaster waffles that are apparently fucking gluten-free. It's fine, we'll be okay. Anyways, then I got the goods. These are the greatest things that Trader Joe's sells. I will live by them. I got my roommate hooked on them. I don't even know how to explain how amazing they are, but they're the chocolate lava cakes. You can find them in the freezer section. There's two in a pack, and you like warm them up for like 50 seconds or so, and chef's kiss, literally amazing. I feel like, just look at it, it looks like the lava cakes that you get from nice restaurants. And the next thing, I got cheese pizza, and then I got a gluten-free cheese pizza. This one my roommate ate last time, and then I smelled it and it smelled really good, and so I got it. And then this one's not gluten-free because I'm not gluten-free, and I saw a frat boy picking it up, so it looks easy enough to make. And then I got some eggs because I haven't had eggs in so long, and I usually have eggs for breakfast, so I don't know what I've been eating. Actually, I've literally been eating chicken pot stickers for breakfast because I haven't had eggs. Kind of gross, whatever. Usually get the macaroni. It cooks the easiest. I feel like the rigatoni from Trader Joe's cooks a bit hard. Weird, but it does. And then my roommate bought this the first time around, and it was really good. It's the organic pasta. It's like vegetable. I could not say the second word. And it, like, the texture of it and the shape, just 10 out of 10. Amazing. Yeah, so I'm really excited to eat these. Next, I forgot. I think I just started throwing stuff at my cart at this point. I always eat this salad mix. Really good. Even like I do it before like I eat Asian food, and I do it before I eat like pastas and stuff. Like, then I got brown sugar, which is a huge pack of brown sugar, but I just need it for my Thai food, but I thought I could use it for baking and stuff like that. And then I just, at this point, I think I just started like throwing shit into my cart that just looked good, which is so just not smart, but I literally shop like once a month. So I got these chicken cilantro mini wontons. Usually I get the chicken gyozas, which are bigger, but I think I overate them. Like, I ate too many of them, and now I just can't eat anymore because they taste really gross to me, which is really sad because I love them. And I got spaghetti cacio e pepe, which looks wonderful, amazing. Not as good as going out to like a restaurant, but like I have to eat. I got French onion macaroni and cheese. Oh, it looks so, this could be an aesthetic nail photo. Look at that. That looks really hot. Like if I saw that, I'd be like, okay. Trader Joe's, just screenshot this right here and post it. People will 100% buy it. Anyways, this just looks dank as fuck. I don't know what else to say. And I got chicken for my Penang curry. The fact that I had to buy all of the ingredients because I own nothing, it's just very sad. But anyways, then I feel like every brown person, every Asian person is about to roast me. I used to just buy like a bag of rice from like Costco and then cook it myself, but brown rice fully took me, it would take 45 minutes to cook the way that I liked it. And then I bought boxed rice for the first time and my life was changed. You can make it in 5 minutes and the texture is just insane. So yeah, like a little bitch, now I buy boxed organic rice. And yeah, I'm embarrassed. That's all I'm gonna say about it. We're not gonna talk about it. If you'd like to roast me in the comments, go for it. I feel like a shitty brown person for not making my own rice. Then I got this bread. It is gluten-free bread. And let me tell you, this is the greatest bread I've ever tasted. I'm not a huge bread girl, but I could eat this whole thing for dinner tonight and be very happy with my life. It's just like, once you toast it, the texture, 10 out of 10. This stuff's good. Then I got peanut butter. I don't eat peanut butter, but I got it for Thai food. I got a whole jar of peanut butter just so I can make Thai food. And then, oh, I forgot I got these. Wild. Oh my God, they're reduced guilt. That's kind of gross. I don't really fuck with things that are like reduced guilt or like healthy. Like if I'm gonna eat pasta, it better contain every single calorie. Like be like 1,000 calories and up. But anyways, these are spinach and cheese stuffed shells with marinara sauce. They look really good. I feel like I'm gonna open them and they're gonna look like some rank ass shit, but until then, they look really good. Plus when you're hungry, I could literally eat anything. And last but not least, I got 3 limes because I don't know how much juice 3 limes makes, but I needed a certain amount of juice for my Penang curry. Say it with me, Penang curry. And
she's looking good though, yeah.
Thank you for pulling up. I will see you next week. I post on Fridays, so next Friday. Just so that I'm feeling safer. Fendi on my body, but my feet is a bodega. And I'm getting money, it's a whole lot of